It's a centuries-old skill set dating back to the Middle Ages, but demand for a blacksmith has diminished greatly thanks to modern manufacturing techniques. There's now just one left in Sydney, where the sparks are still flying.
The escalator that ramps you to Sydney's last industrial blacksmith is like a time tunnel from when the Everly Railway Workshops were the largest enterprise in Australia. A true melting pot where you would see Fiji Bob to sign up with your workshop soccer team. The workshops would close in the late 80s, but the beaks of anvils still peep round corners at the Everly Works.
It hasn't been gutted, it hasn't been cleaned out. We've still got all of the original tools that the blacksmiths over the generations have made in this room. Some of the machines in here date back to the Industrial Revolution, so we're talking about late 19th century.
But now, instead of building the iron horse, the blacksmith's workshop is a space for artists like Sam Kirby.
You have to hit it with confidence.
Trepidation has no place here.
No, I don't think so. I think if you're timid, the metal's not going to move for you.
James Livesey trained in England for what is described as traditional blacksmithing.
Bloke standing in a dark shed with a big beard and a beer belly, obviously.
Pliable Sydney sandstone would mean blacksmiths here would not hold the industrial profile as in the British Isles.
And when you bring over a convict colony of a bunch of blokes who can cut stone, you build everything out of stone, right?
But given the workshop's importance to Australia's early growth, keeping the smithy going has been a key element to develop a Mervac's refurbishment of the workshop precinct.
And the whole idea was to celebrate as much of the history of this site.
This place built the rails that got the wheat and the wool to port.
Mike Dalton, Nine News.